concerted effort, pulling those strengths, those individual strengths together to deliver on November 6th. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Gayanne. I'm glad that I didn't have to give a speech 4 years ago until it was all done. All right, so we are now to the voting process. County chairs, if you could please, and legislative district chairs, if you could please stand. Verify with the staff that's handing out the ballots the number of delegates and properly seated alternates that you have, and we'll give you that number of ballots. Then it'll be your job to collect those ballots after you've distributed them and everyone's voted, and hand them back to one of the staff. We will have three people counting the votes behind the curtain here. One of our parliamentarians, one of our sergeant-at-arms, and our party general counsel. If you are close enough that we can make out who one of the two names is, that's good enough. Barry, Gayanne, Gayanne, Barry, Peterson, DeMorda, whatever. The counters will be able to figure it out. So if you write legibly, we'll figure that out. If anyone has any Donna Jones cards, you can give those to the staff as well during the process this afternoon. That'd be great. Staff's making their way down the road here. When you are done voting, we need the two candidates for chairman to designate for us an observer to observe the vote count. You're entitled, each chairman candidate, to have one person witness the counting by the three individuals I just mentioned. If you can just let me know who those are before the box is taken behind the curtain. Thank you. walking around with.
Thank you.
elected, correct? Are there any outstanding ballots? Okay, the three counters have taken, do we have all of the ballots? You guys have none, right? Right here?
Good luck.
They've all been dumped in the box. The counters are back there with an observer from each campaign observing the vote. One of the reasons we have them back here instead of doing it out here is because we will now continue with the next nominations while they're counting, okay? So next is first vice chair. The first vice chair. So nominations are now open for the first vice chair from Ada County. Does Ada County have a nomination for first vice chair? Nomination of Ron Nate has been placed for first vice chair. Adams County. And we do not need a second for any of these. Just, you know, Bannock.
Pass.
Bear Lake. Benoit. Bingham. Blaine. Name of Chick Hylison has been placed in nomination for first vice chair. Where did I leave off? Boise next. Pass. Bonner. Bonneville. Boundary. Butte. Camas. Canyon. There's no second. Caribou. You counties can defer to another county if you want, just a clue here. Caribou. It's been in motion for nominations to cease in a second. We're not through all the counties yet. Let's bear the motion in a second, so we'll have to vote on it. All those in favor of the nomination ceasing, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
No.
I think there's another candidate, folks. So, it never works out very good trying to shut people off. I'm just letting you know. Okay. We were at Cassia. Cassia is deferring to Twin Falls, is that correct? Or to Legislative 24, or what did I hear? Where's Cassia? Cassia? Yes, what's your... The name of Mike Matthews has been placed in the nomination for first vice chair. Do any of the other counties or legislative districts intend to place a name in a nomination? If not, there is a motion to cease nominations with the three names and a second. All those in favor of ending the nomination process with the three, say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed? All right, nominations are ceased. So we will do the same drill. You don't have to have two nominating or seconding speeches, but you can. So in the order they were nominated, does everybody remember? Ron Nate, Chick Hylison, Mike Matthews. So a 3-minute nominating speech, up to two 1-minute seconding speeches, and then the candidate. Okay, so let's get Ron's team up here. When they're done, then we'll see Chick's team up here, and then Mike's team.
Thank you, Norm. Delegates, friends, it gives me a great deal of pleasure to place the name of Ron Nate in nomination for the position of first vice chairman for the Iowa Republican Party. Let me give you a few reasons why. I know Ron Nate, he's a friend of mine, and Ron Nate is one heck of a guy. In addition to that, he's a doctor. He doesn't like people to say that too often because they expect him to do some medical procedures on him. He's a doctor of economics. But let me tell you a little bit more about Ron Nate. I don't know how many of you know Sheila Olson, but he married her daughter, so he's in a political family. I first got to know Ron a number of years ago when this body, the Idaho Republican Party, chose to make itself a more meaningful party. We chose to engage